right, so from the snapdowns that we saw, variety of snapdowns, either way, we're looking for one thing. I'm looking for your axles, posture broken and getting down, preferably to this position. When he's on his elbows and knees, it's a long way up, okay? And when you're on stage with these people, you can bet that this is where they're gonna land. For Axel to get up from here, he needs to get up on his hands first, probably, and then on his feet, and then build a baseline back to a standing position. So, as snapping down, we're gonna start with this kind of situation where he actually felt his elbows, okay? So when I snap him down, let's say I didn't go behind. I'm gonna give myself a few more options. I snap him down, I'm gonna throw into a front headlock from here, okay? When I do the front headlock, I have options. I can go for the chin strap, which is the most common one. I could go for a grip right here with a little more angle on two knees, kind of like this. Let's go with the chin strap for the moment. When he's on his elbows, his hands are free, okay? His hand is free to move around and all that, because he's not posting on his hand, right? So if I go for a front headlock from here and I start hunting for guillotines, all I'm doing is giving him my hand. If he gets my hand here, very often, jiu-jitsu people especially, because we're used to falling to the elbows and hunting for guillotines, he's gonna pin my hand to the floor and just circle around or something like that, or maybe pull guard, whatever his game is from there. The fact of the matter is, I'm giving him his hand, giving him my hand to trap it as I go and hunt for submissions. I gotta know that as soon as he goes to his elbows, those guillotines and anacondas and stuff like this are almost out of the window, right? So, what I'll do instead is I'm gonna go behind. It's very easy because he's not being able to trap me. He's on his elbow and he tries to stop. He's not on his elbow and he tries to stop my go behind. So just come up to him, try to stop my go behind, open your arm. He's right there opening his arm and ready for it. He's on his elbow, all his weight is down. And when I try to go behind, it's very hard for him to open this arm and stop my go behind, okay? So the first thing I'm gonna do is block this possible stopper, okay? Numerous ways to block it. I can block it with my hand here, just like this, and start driving behind. Then I'm gonna transition this hand that was here in front of his shoulder. It's just gonna come up backhand behind him, okay, behind the tricep. So for that purpose, I'm gonna move my shoulder up, put this hand here on the tricep to block, then I'm gonna start walking around. Okay, I can shuffle, walk, whatever, or jump. This hand is gonna go on the tricep. Then I'm gonna consolidate the position behind his back. Anytime I go into the top turtle position behind his back, I wanna have my hands behind his elbows. If I make a mistake and get behind his back and throw a seatbelt, like this, he's just gonna walk around, chase underhook on this side or a leg, and go on the attack. Okay, so very first action for me would be to block his arm from here. I'm gonna bring my body a little bit higher so I can move around, put my weight on it, re-block, so this hand gets free. So what do we do with this one? I have options. I could go for a butt drag here. I could reach for his leg. These are all good options. What I don't want to do is reach for his waist up here, because that leaves me open to rolls, or it just leaves his hips open to getting up, right? So I want my left arm, the one that's initializing the block here, to go either around his butt, around his leg, or more, not high or waist. I'm gonna go from here, block, up, re-block, here, and get behind, okay? A couple more times up the floor. We fell right off the snap. This guy decides to go down to his knees and elbows. First situation, I get my front headlock from here. I don't have to waste a lot of time here because there's nothing for me in terms of guillotines. There might be, but low percentage. I'm gonna start going behind. Okay, the more I give him my hand here, the harder it will be. So, fall in here, get the chin, nothing there. Post, however you wanna do it. The first one is not that imperative. Go up here, and I go behind, okay? Let's give it a try. Bear up by size, because it's going to be very hard to bear someone's weight. Start from snap the other person down. The person that gets snapped down, just
pull to your elbows and knees. Okay, like
well, jiu-jitsu person,
when you guys snap, you're gonna pull them down to their hands.
Hands, like, forward point.
And just shoot to a front headlock, and then you can just draw back. You can just use a front headlock to pull them down further, even if it's just like a, don't even go all the way down. Just here. Pull them down.
Give it a try, guys. His elbows, right? He fell onto his elbows. That's a great story. But most of the time, I snap him down. And by the way, we had that question. If I snap him down and I move to the side, I'm already behind him. I don't need to move in front of him. Most of the time, when I snap him down, I'm very strong snapping with my elbows towards my body and not so strong snapping to the side, right? Kind of like requires momentum, a couple of errors on his part, or very good setups on my part. So when
also,
I snap him,
yeah, elbows are going to square up into.
Probably, yes. There you go. So we're going to land most of the time, if we both know what we're doing, most of the time we're going to land in this kind of position, right? So this is where the front headlock's coming. Now, I get to this position, snap him down, but this time he posted on his hand, right? He's ready to get up, and I realize that my weight is on him, but I need to break him down, okay? So, a couple of ways to do that. Like you said, one way would be for me to grab his shin right here, and he's not able to defend his shin right now. We're assuming that today we're snapping down and going behind, not going for attacks, okay? That we're gonna do that next week. I'm gonna break him down to elbows first. Why? Because if he sits back and I try to go behind, sit back as I go behind, and open your arm, he's stopping, right? So he's gonna fall down. Here comes a scramble. I wanna break him to an elbow. Less mobility for him, better for me. More mobility for me. So I'm gonna break him down to an elbow. Options, I can just run around, grab his chin as I'm doing that, pull him this way. It's gonna break his posture, so break his sock over. So as we land here, I notice he's on his hands. Right here. I'm pulling his head literally into it as my weight stays on top. Option number two would be from here, what he did earlier, literally just throw him back down. So here, I'm gonna throw back down. Right here, right? Same result, okay? It's a little more violent because I can drop my weight onto him. We're going to explore both options. Be careful with the second one because you really drop your weight onto him. Now let's say we go to the first. I'm going to drive him in to the elbow. See where it's going to square, right? Now, from here, we're going to explore another option for go behind. Let's say it's not your thing to go here and here, right? Go here and here. Another way to do it is, can do a knee block. I'm gonna block here. Now I'm halfway there. It sets up really good for crucifixes. If the guy doesn't know what he's doing, he grabs onto my leg here. Great. Going for crucifix, right? Most of the time he'll know what he's doing, he's not gonna try that, but he can pull his elbow back because I'm blocking that. I get my arm behind, go here, depending on what I can do. Here is the best. Pull the and I keep going. So this is a knee block, not a hand block. I brought him down to his elbows, from his hands, we're gonna drill that. From here, bring him down to elbows. Now we're gonna do, bring him down to his elbows, square up. This time, I'm gonna do a knee block. Slide my rear knee forward. This one is gonna fall right behind his tricep. And I get my hands behind. One hand to the butt or near the hip, as long as it's closer to the hip and not over here. The other one, rear blocks. To replace my knee, and I keep going. He makes a mistake. He grabs onto my leg here. You can go to a crucifix, but let's not drill that now because it's kind of not the subject. Okay? Let's give it a try, guys.